Good morning. I didn't know you were going to turn the camera on while I'm eating my Samoans. Yes. These are the caramel flavored ones, are the best ones actually. Girl Scout cookies. You're watching day one of the FLW Tour Lake Cumberland tournament video where Billy and I are going to go freeze our tail off today. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's cold. I had flip flops on yesterday. Now I'm layered up. I have my insulated boots because it's going to rain. I have my face mask and gloves. Ooh, where's the face mask? Oh, it's over here. And I have a helmet. What are we going to do? Hopefully we're going to catch a bunch of little smallmouth. It is time to go to the boat ramp, my friend. You ready?
All right.
Yeah. So stay tuned. Day one, FLW Tour. Lake Cumberland starts right now.
Good luck, Scott.
Good luck, Scott.
Are you?
I'm hot.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Hope we can get out of here. Four-wheel drive, baby.
Four-wheel drive.
We're in line for the boat ramp. We're running a little bit late because this line's slow. So again, we got a little bit of weather coming in, guys, but you know, I don't think the water temperature is going to drop that much, but here's what we're doing today. Obviously, in this video, we're going to be filming the entire tournament for you guys, hopefully 4 days.
Good morning.
Good morning, Scott.
Wataru, right?
Yes, Wataru, yes.
Yes. All right. And you're from Japan,
yes,
right?
I'm from Japan.
What part?
I'm from close to Tokyo.
Oh, I've been to Tokyo. Oh. I've been to Lake Kawaguchi.
Oh, Lake Kawaguchi. Oh, I live there.
Yes. And I went to the top of Mount Fuji.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, volcano, very tall.
Not sure how much we're going to have this big camera out today with all the rain, but looking forward to it. It's going to be a good day. Stay tuned. Big smallmouth coming up. A big smallmouth, big smallmouth.
Yes!
Big smallmouth, boys. I know he's 18, but I'll measure him anyways. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's good. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Big fish, big fish. Big fish. Big smallmouth. Yes!
Oh, nice one!
Ooh.
Hey, good job!
That's a big one, boys.
That's so close.
I told you, big smallmouth.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. That's number two, big smallmouth. Good stuff, boys. Net. Oh my gosh, giant one, 5-6 pounder. Oh my gosh, six pounder. Maybe I can catch him tomorrow or later today. Giant, that was a giant, unbelievable. Net, big one. Thank you. Maybe. Big one. Get net. Yes! Woo!
Yeah!
Oh.
What the
big one? Oh my gosh. Hooked in the back. Look at that, look. It fell out.
Oh my gosh.
Good job.
Thank you, Lord. Oh my goodness. Wow.
Wow, this is a wow.
Wow. The one earlier was bigger than that. Big one. Yes.
Good job.
Thank you. All right, guys. That's a good one right there. That's a good one. We need to go. I have a good bag. We need to get close to weigh in. Because we got an hour and 5 minutes right now.
Yeah.
We need to go. In case there's a breakdown.
Yes.
All right, guys. We're pretty much done for the day. What a blessing. I tell you, it's just an amazing day. I caught some really good fish. Got some four big smallmouth and one big largemouth. We got about 20 minutes to fish, and I'm not even fishing anymore. I'm actually letting my partner, he's been such a good partner, just letting him fish. I'm just going down the bank here. Hopefully he'll catch a couple nice bass here. So, I don't know, pretty cool. Pretty intense, wouldn't you agree? Golly, a couple of those fish were just amazing. Unbelievable. And then that big one that I lost, that was crazy. You having fun?
Yeah.
Here comes Brandon. You're gonna catch them tomorrow.
Yeah, I will.
Yes, you will. You know, the deal is, guys, today's the day that those smallmouth are gonna bite because it's overcast, rainy, stormy conditions. They like that. Tomorrow, it's gonna be wind and sun. I think I can still catch them tomorrow. Saturday, it's gonna be dead calm and bright sun. Could be tough, but maybe I can catch those big spotted bass that I found and survive with some big spots. So we'll see what happens. Number one. It was a good day. I lost one that was bigger than that biggest one. Like a foot from the net, dude. He stuck the net down the water. I thought maybe he got it. It was like a 6-pounder, dude. Giant. Yeah, dude, I hung this big one. And I was fighting it and jumping everywhere. And I step backwards, he's got the net stuck out. And I'm pulling the fish on the surface. And the jerkbait flies out of its mouth. And the fish just goes. He sticks the net down. I'm thinking, oh, please, please get it. He didn't get it. But he did good. I don't know, I bet it might weigh 18 or so, I hope. We'll see.
Billy get a bass?
Hey!
Billy's got one bass.
Billy got one 8-pound bass.
All right, Scott, come on up. Scott Martin. Scott Martin, who's won $2.5 million. He's an Angler of the Year winner. He's got 16 Forest Wood Cup bursts. He's a Forest Wood Cup champion. 6 tour level wins. And one of the greatest names in the sport today, man. A legend in this game, Scott Martin from Clewiston, Florida. A 5-bass limit on day one. Scott, to take the lead from Casey Scanlon, you need 18 pounds and 9 ounces. 5-bass limit for Scott Martin. Worth, new leader. 19 pounds and 7 ounces. You got the lead by 15 ounces. Let's see your 2-bass bass. Take them all the way to the front center, Scott, and smile, man, for the folks watching you on FLW Live.
Tom, what do you think you got?
What's that?
What do you think you got?
3, man. What's that?
You just got 3, but what do you think you weigh?
2 pounds.
2 pounds? Tom.
Good morning. Day 2, FLW Tour event. Yeah, and my hair is messed up. Yeah. Oh, man, I need a hat, dude. All right, here we go. All right, what's up, guys? Day 2. FLW Tour event, we're doing pretty good. I'm excited. Snagged me up a couple big old smallmouth yesterday. That was pretty cool, crazy fights. So what do I gotta do today? I gotta try to duplicate that. I gotta somehow figure out a way to catch a pretty big bag of fish. Billy's gotta catch a big old bag of fish. Tom's gotta catch a big old bag of fish. Yeah, we've got some work to do. It's all great to be leading the tournament, but I can't weigh in any of the fish that I caught yesterday today. That's a fact. We know that for a fact. None of the ones I caught yesterday, can't weigh them in today. I gotta catch new ones. I spent a lot of time last night on Google Earth looking around at some places that might hold some fish. So, let's get after it.
All right, Carl, good morning.
Good morning.
Carl is from Snell Grove, Georgia. Isn't that right?
Oh, Snellville.
Snellville. I always call it Snell Grove. That's all right.
All right. Totally different weather this morning, guys. I mean, I can actually see the sky. No rain. It's cold, but it's not raining. So it's hard to say what's going to happen. I think the smallmouth will keep biting. I really do. And the big spots might show up today. So we'll just, hey, we're going to go have fun. We're going to make some adjustments along the way, fish some new water. Looking forward to it. So, oh, here we go, boys. There's one. Got one. I think it's a little, that's a spot.
Spot?
Yeah. Okay. A spot. I guess it's a spot. Looks like a spot to me. Yeah, it's a spot. Definitely got a red eyes. Mm-hmm. Big one, big one, big one. Right there, right there. There you go. Oh, he fell off too. fell off. Look at that fat spot. Whoo! I don't care how I get there. I don't care what species it is, as long as I get the weight I need. Net. Thank you, Lord. They're small, but they count. Got him. Got him. Fish. It's a smallmouth. There you go. Whoa. Okay, get in there. Thank you. Probably short. 18. Woo! Oh, big fish. Coming up. He's one hook. Oh, yes. He came off, dude, in the net. What I'm talking about, baby. Oh, what a net job, baby. Net job. All right, we made it back in time.
And my partner, he survived. he had a tough day.
Yeah,
but he survived.
It was a tough day, huh?
You know, it's a breakdown for today. I ran all kind of new water, which is fun. I love those type of tournaments where you just literally fish new water the entire time. I didn't catch any fish on any of the places that I'd fished yesterday. So, you know, if I make the cut, I'm going to do that again. You know, I had some opportunities. I saw one really big smallmouth come right to the boat. It actually hit me. And I lost another one that looked pretty good. So I could have culled up a little bit. So we'll see what happens. If those largemouths show up in those trees, it could be big. If I can figure out how to catch them, they're a little tricky. They didn't show up today. I think it was a water temperature. But tomorrow it's going to be warmer and calm. And if those big largemouth start suspending in those trees, I can catch them either on a jerk bait or on a fluke or some type of swim bait or something. So that's all I got. Let's go weigh them in.
All right, to regain your lead from Clark Winlet, you need 15 pounds and 15 ounces. To bust into the top 20, you need just 7.6. Here we go. Scott Martin, a 5-bass limit today. You followed him all day on flwfishing.com, on FLW on the Twitter feed. His limit today, were 12 pounds even, got you in fifth place with 31 pounds and 7 ounces. You'll fish another day, Scotty. All right, big bass lead on the pro side, 6.4.
All right, so in FLW, people always ask, well, why don't just people cheat in bass tournaments? Well, because they do lie detector tests randomly. So if you're in the top 20, or if you're leading the tournament or all things like that, they do a lie detector, and several people had to take one, and they chose me today. So I got to go in there with that guy, and he's got to hook me up to a machine and ask me a bunch of questions to make sure that I played within the rules. So I'll be back in a minute. I'm kind of nervous.
No lying.
Well, wait, he's got to take you in there now.
What? For real?
Yeah, for real.
You got a second? I got a couple.
Okay.
A couple questions for you.
I've never done this before.
There's some questions I'm going to ask you that only you would know concerning Scott. There's.
Is this a setup?
Is this? No, this is.
To make sure that you didn't do anything weird.
I got to make sure that that you're not aware of anything, any rules that he violated. And I'm just going to ask you a couple questions real quick before we get started. Yeah, I know you work with Scott. I know you travel with Scott. There's been some questions or maybe some. Maybe not necessarily doing anything wrong, but maybe kind of bending the rules a little bit. And I just want to know, I just want you to be honest, you know?
Yeah.
You spent time with him. There's been some questions about, you know, maybe some fishing some off-limits period. And that, that only you would have been with him or getting some information about this tournament that you would know about. And I just, are you willing to take a test for me to ask some questions on whether or not you're telling the truth?
Yeah.
You know, all right. Scott's had fun with you today.
I knew it was a setup. I knew it. I was ready for it. I was like, I've never taken a polygraph before. I was ready.
Is it in your chest?
Right. Oh, my chest is beat.
All right, we got to go. We got to go, Brandon. Come on. We got to go to the meeting. Go over there to the meeting.
Matthew,
we're at the meeting
Matthew,
now.
Your,
this yeah, is where we do the
no
top 20 meeting.
Mechanical issues, where
we get,
correct?
We go over the rules okay. Again.
Chris, would you
and
call
tell us what
Scott,
we're going to be doing tomorrow, what time we come
those
in.
Guys know that they're good.
All okay. This good stuff. So,
okay, I'm going to call the rolls. So I need everyone's attention.
We'll call
again.
And roll now. We'll call and roll. All right, so meeting's over. It's time to go to the house. It's time to get a couple rods rigged up and get to bed. Let's go. Day three, that's what today is. I'm a little dragging. Got drainage, I don't know if it's the, what is that, allergies or something, or am I getting sick? Man, I don't know what it is, bad. I can barely talk, I feel like I'm about to cough. Not as much craziness going on in the house this morning. Billy's up, made me some coffee this morning, thank you, Billy. We have Brandon, here's a typical morning for Brandon. It's not really actually typical, because I usually am not posting videos at 5:30 in the morning, but since he's gonna go on the water today and watch me fish, he's been a little quiet.
I told Billy to bring some rods.
Yeah?
He said, we ain't fishing. I said, what?
Dude, I'm in the finals, man. I mean, you can't be fishing. What happens if you catch one? That would be bad. Like, if you're watching me and you cast over.
That
and...
just shows I should be in the tournament.
Really? You see what I'm doing? Day three starts now. All right, Kevin. Kevin is my marshal today. Nice to meet you, Kevin.
Nice to meet you.
All right, so today.
There is no co-anglers, guys. We don't have a co-angler. We have marshals.
He can't net my fish. He can hand me a drink. Go ahead, Billy. He can hand me a drink. He can give me a pack of crackers if I need them. He can give me mental and moral support. But he cannot net a fish. He's just here to hang out and film. FLW Live, right?
That's right. I got my iPad, and that's all I'm going to do.
All right.
Awesome. So watch you fish for 8 hours.
Awesome.
9 hours, whatever it is.
All right. Good looking spot right here. There's one. Big smallmouth. Yes! Woo, boys! Look at that tank. Oh, that's a big one. That's a big one. Wow. That is a good one. No need to measure him. Lake Cumberland, FLW, day three. This is the way to start, my friend. Right there. Get four more bites like this. We're going to make it interesting. Good one. Oh, yes. Ha ha ha. All right, guys. Just got me a nice big spotted bass. Check that guy out right there. You know, one of the little bonuses with what I'm doing is I'm catching some big spots. Two and a quarter pound spots, and that's one of them right there. I've got one big smallmouth already. It's early in the morning. You know, it takes all day. That's the thing. You know, I don't have a spot. I'm just running new water. I've never fished this bank before in my life. Big old spots, throwing a jerk bait. Awesome stuff.
Oh,
find him, Billy?
Yeah, so we found Scott. I don't know that he has any fish yet.
Big one. Yeah. Largemouth. I'm telling you, based on what I'm seeing so far, 2.5, 3-pounder back there, 3 giant ones back there, another largemouth here. If I keep running this pattern, keep running new water, pay attention to everything around me, there's potential today to catch a big bag of fish.
Okay, so here's where we are. Scott just caught another fish. He's caught like, I don't know, 6 or 7 fish, but this one was a keeper. It was about 2.5 pounds of largemouth. So that puts him at right at 9 pounds, I think. So things are starting to heat up, getting better. Yeah.
Oh, it's a big one, dude. A big one. Giant. I mean, a giant. Oh my gosh, you pulled off.
He said, hold the position for dramatic pause.
I have no words right now, man. That was giant. Big one. Oh. Yeah, finally. All right, 2-pounder or 2-something. All right, I like it. I like it. 2:45. We gotta be back at 3:30, right? Yeah, it's 3:30. Big one. Oh my gosh. Yeah! Woo! That's good stuff right there, boys. 2:33-something.
Spot.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go see what the scoop is. All right, so we're getting ready to go weigh these puppies in. Hopefully it's enough to fish tomorrow. I think it is, but you know, I think anybody in the top 10's got an opportunity to win this thing. It's gonna be a pretty tight weight-wise. I mean, it's not gonna be but a couple pounds separating first through 10th. Got guys like Brian Thrift in the finals.
I'm not gonna be there tomorrow.
You might be, you never know.
I know I'm not.
You were a 4.
I figured it out.
Really?
Yeah, I'll be like 12. 13.
Well, that's actually a good thing. I actually have more confidence now that I actually have a better shot of winning, because if he's in the finals, he catches them on the last day somehow. But anyways, we're gonna go see what they weigh. See what happens.
5 today, a limit of bass for Scott Martin Worth, new leader. 14 pounds, 14 ounces, you got the lead. Wow!
I'm not used to all this cold weather. I live down in South Florida, so it was a little tough on me the last couple days, but I'm looking forward to maybe wearing flip-flops tomorrow. So if I break out my flip-flops, some bad things are gonna happen to these boys, I promise you.
So we're in second. Clark Wingle's leading. He's gonna be a force to be reckoned with tomorrow. So I got my work cut out. There's all these guys, it's close weight. So whoever catches the biggest bag tomorrow is gonna win this thing.
How about that, guys? Second place. Pretty cool, huh? Thanks for following along so far. I know this is probably turning into a long video, but I've got a chance to win this tournament. How crazy would that be to win this tournament with you guys? So, you know, I'm not really sure exactly where I'm gonna fish today. I just know that there is potential. There is potential. It's supposed to be the warmest day of the year. Let me rephrase that. It's supposed to be the warmest day of the week. Bring my flip-flops, baby. Oh yeah. I'll get comfortable. Hopefully I'll make some good decisions, some good casts, because that's what it's going to take. Clark Bennett's leading the tournament. He's got about a 3-pound lead, which is a lot on this lake. What do I need to catch? Everything I can. You know when some people are right on the edge? They're right on the edge and you feel it and you know it. And you're like, I need to just... I need to just leave them alone. That's where we're at. Day 4 starts now. All right, let's say a little prayer. Lord, we love you. Father, I pray that we shoot some awesome TV today. Father, that you provide me an opportunity to catch the biggest bag that I've caught here. Father, and just allow me to see these special little spots. Allow me to make the right cast and allow me to get these fish in the boat. And thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. It's funny, yesterday I was rigging all my rods up there at the boatyard, and my buddies that travel with me, they're like, I'm gonna go down and go fishing down by the bank while you're doing all this. And I grabbed two of my like main rods, like the ones I'm fishing in the tournament with, and started walking down to the bank, and I'm like, dude, what are you doing? Like, I got a whole bunch of rods and you want to fish with the ones that I'm like rigging up? Like, go down and get my jerkbait all hung up in the tree or something? Right. Lost your mind. Hopefully I catch one of them. God almighty, I just had another one follow it. Just had a good one follow it. That was kind of cool. He followed it to the boat. Stayed right there on it. Yeah. Small one, but... it's about a pound and a quarter more than I had a minute ago. Oh, there's two of them. Oh my gosh! Dang it! I went and net the fish and hit the jerkbait. It was a 3-pounder, 2 3/4, and there was another one with him. Oh my gosh. Oh, woohoo, boys. I don't know if we're live or not, but that was live. Oh my goodness gracious. He jumped into the bait that I had hanging over the side of the boat. And all I kept thinking was, he's gonna pull off. There's fish in that tree, I can see him. There he is, it's a big one too. It's a big one, dude, it's a big one. Oh my gosh, it's a big largemouth. Yes! Boom! Woo! I saw the fish in the tree. I'm not kidding. I just said it. Right there, boys. Baby, oh, I don't deserve to catch fish like this, but I sure am glad, and I did it for you, darling. That's for my wife right there. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh! Dude, it was a giant, dude. It's a big one, dude. Yeah! That's amazing, dude. That's amazing.
All right, Brandon. I'm in.
You are.
I'm in. We had fun today, didn't we?
We had a lot of fun.
Stressful, though.
All right, guys, so we're going to go weigh these fish in. I don't know what I have, but I caught a nice one there at the end that's going to help me a little bit, but that's about all I got. So we'll see what happens. We're about halfway through the weigh-in. Scott Canterbury's going up. Clark Wendland hadn't gone up yet. He's leading the tournament. He's got like a 4-pound lead on me. I hear chatter that Barry Wilson's got a pretty good bag, so it's gonna be interesting. It's gonna be real interesting. Good event, win, lose, or draw. And again, I appreciate all the support, guys. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Do me a favor, if you like the video, share it. Let everybody know what's going on. And you need to check out the practice video. For whatever reason, the practice video is not getting a lot of views, but let me tell you, it's the funniest, best edited video we have on the channel. So go check out practice video for Lake Cumberland. I promise you, it's awesome. You're gonna love it.
Welcome Trocar, Evinrude, Ranger Pro, Scott Martin. All right, here we go. Scott Martin, one of the biggest names in professional bass fishing. All right, Scott, we're gonna put four in, and I'm gonna tell you what you need to dethrone Barry Wilson. First one is a good one. Keeper spot. We're going to get to watch Scott Martin catch some fish today on Lake Cumberland as well. Here in just a minute. Fish number two. Wow, God. Wow! Three and four. Wow! That's your third and fourth fish. Two good ones. To dethrone Barry Wilson, the Evinrude Pro, you need 12 pounds and 1 ounce. So you need number five. Five today for Scott Martin. Wow! A five bass limit for the Florida Pro. Wow! Getting it done on Championship Sunday. 13 pounds, 12 ounces. He's your new leader. Wow! Getting it done. 60 pounds and 1 ounce. And that's got him in first place, but we've got one guy left, and he has led this thing. And I can tell you what, a former Angler of the Year three times.
This is kind
of
crazy.
Angler of the Year, and a guy who knows how to close. This is not going to be easy for you, Scott. Let's bring him up, Mike. What you got, Clark?
I tell you what, some days just go that way. I had a great tournament. I fish for smallmouth all week, and those smallmouth can be fickle, though. And, you know, I didn't catch a bass today, though. Scott Martin.
Your champion is Scott Martin! Wow! $125,000 richer is the Florida Pro, Scott Martin. He wins his seventh FLW Tour event. Former Cup champion. Former Angler of the Year. And to present the winner's check, $125,000, the Vice President of TH Marine, Greg Bowie.
Scott, on behalf of TH Marine, we congratulate you on this awesome win here on beautiful Lake Cumberland.
Thank you so much.
$125,000 richer, Florida Scott Martin.
Thank you, guys.
This event presented by TH Marine, sponsor that's taking this game to the next level. Thank you so much, the Vice President of TH Marine, that is Greg Bowie.
Guys, we did it. Was that crazy or what? Woo. Whoever dislikes this video, I'm unsubscribing you, okay? If you dislike this video, you're barred for life. Appreciate you watching, guys. Stay tuned. We got more stuff coming, more tournaments coming. Thanks for subscribing. Share the video, and I'm out.